Once again, we remind you, if you've just arrived, there are worship aids at all four of the main entrances of the church. You'll need one to participate in tonight's liturgy. Feel free to get one. Thank you.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, on this most sacred night in which our Lord Jesus Christ passed over from death to life, the Church calls upon her sons and daughters scattered throughout the world to come together to watch and pray. If we keep the memorial of the Lord's Paschal solemnity in this way, listening to his word and celebrating his mysteries, then we shall have the sure hope of sharing his triumph over death and living with him in God. Let us pray. O God, who through your Son bestowed upon the faithful the fire of your glory, sanctify this new fire, we pray, and grant that by these Paschal celebrations we may be so inflamed with heavenly desires that with minds made pure we may attain festivities of unending splendor, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Christ yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega, all time belongs to him, and all the ages, to him be glory and power through every age and forever. Amen. By his holy and glorious wounds, may Christ the Lord guard us and protect us. Amen. May the light of Christ rising in glory dispel the darkness of our hearts and minds.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
Exalt, let them exalt, the hosts of heaven exalt. Let angel ministers of God exalt. Let the trumpet of salvation sound. Aloud our mighty kings triumph. Be glad, let earth be glad. As glory floods her ablaze with light from her eternal King, let all corners of the earth be glad, knowing an end to gloom and darkness. Rejoice, let Mother Church also rejoice, arrayed with the lighting of His glory. Let this holy building shake with joy, filled with the mighty voices of the peoples. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, with ardent love of mind and heart and devoted service of our voice, to acclaim our God invisible, the Almighty Father, and Jesus Christ our Lord, His Son, His only begotten, who for our sake paid Adam's debt to the eternal Father, pouring out His own dear blood, wiped clean the record of our ancient sinfulness. These then are the feasts of Passover, which is slain the Lamb, the one true Lamb, whose blood anoints the doorposts of believers. This is the night when once you led our forebears, Israel's children, from slavery in Egypt and made them pass dry shod through the Red Sea. This is the night that with a pillar of fire banished the darkness of sin. This is the night that even now throughout the world sets Christian believers apart from worldly vices and from the gloom of sin, leading them to grace and joining them to His holy ones. This is the night when Christ broke the prisons of death and rose victorious from the underworld. Oh, wonder of your humble care for us. Oh, love, oh, charity beyond all telling. To ransom a slave, you gave away your Son. Oh, truly necessary sin of Adam, destroyed completely by the death of Christ. Oh, happy fault that earned so great so glorious a Redeemer. The sanctifying power of this night dispels wickedness, washes faults away, restores innocence to the fallen, and joy to mourners. Oh, truly blessed night, when things of heaven are wed to those of earth, and divine to the human. On this, your night of grace, O Holy Father, accept this candle, a solemn offering, the work of bees and of your servants' hands, an evening sacrifice of praise, this gift from your most holy church. Therefore, O Lord, we pray you that this candle, hallowed to the honor of your name, may persevere undimmed to overcome the darkness of this night. Receive it as a pleasing fragrance, and let it mingle with the lights of heaven. May this flame be found still burning by the morning star, the one morning star who never sets, Christ your Son, who coming back from death's domain has shed his peaceful light on humanity and lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us listen with quiet hearts to the word of God. Let us meditate on how God in times past saved his people, and in these, the last days, has sent us his Son as our Redeemer. Let us pray that our God may complete this paschal work of salvation by the fullness of redemption. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless wasteland, and darkness covered the abyss, while a mighty wind swept over the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw how good the light was. God then separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. Thus, evening came and morning followed, the first day. Then God said, "Let there be a dome in the middle of the waters to separate one body of water from the other." And so it happened. God made the dome, and it separated the water above from the dome. And it separated the water above the dome from the water below it. God called the dome the sky. Evening came, and morning followed, the second day. Then God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered into a single basin so that the dry land may appear." And so it happened. The water under the sky was gathered into its basin, and the dry land appeared. God called the dry land the earth, and the basin of the water he called the sea. God saw how good it was, and then God said, "Let the earth bring forth vegetation, every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit within it, with its seed in it, and so it happened. The earth brought forth every kind of plant that bared seed and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it. God saw how good it was. Evening came and morning followed, the third day. Then God said, "Let there be light in the dome of the sky to separate day from night. Let them mark the fixed times, the days and the years, and serve as luminaries in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth." And so it happened. God made two great lights, the greater one to govern the day and the lesser one to govern the night. And he made the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. God saw how good it was. Evening came and morning followed, the fourth day. Then God said, "Let the earth, or let the water teem with an abundance of living creatures, and on the earth let birds fly beneath the dome of the sky." And so it happened. God created the great sea monsters and all kinds of swimming creatures with which the water teems, and all kinds of winged birds. God saw how good it was, and God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile, multiply, and fill the waters of the sea, and let the birds multiply on the earth." Evening came and morning followed, the fifth day. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth all kinds of living creatures, cattle, creeping things, and wild animals of all kinds." And so it happened. God made all kinds of wild animals, all kinds of cattle, all kinds of creeping things of the earth. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and the cattle, and over all the wild animals, and all the creatures that crawl on the ground." God created man in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea and the birds of the air, and all the living things that move on the earth." God also said, "See, I give you every seed-bearing plant all over the earth, and every tree that has seed-bearing fruit on it to be your food, and to all the animals of the land, and all the birds of the air, and all the living creatures that crawl on the ground. I give all the green plants for food." And so it happened. God looked at everything he made, and he found it was very good. Evening came and morning followed, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth and all their array were completed, since on the seventh day God was finished. He was finished with the work he had been doing. He rested on the seventh day from all the work he had undertaken. The word of the Lord.
The Lord fills the earth with his love, his love. The Lord fills the earth with his love. The Lord fills the earth with his love.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who are wonderful in the ordering of all your works, may those you have redeemed understand that there exists nothing more marvelous than the world's creation in the beginning, except that at the end of the ages, Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Why are you crying out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward. And you, lift up your staff and, with hand outstretched over the sea, split the sea in two, that the Israelites may pass through it on dry land. But I will make the Egyptians so obstinate that they will go in after them. Then I will receive glory through Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and charioteers. The Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I receive glory through Pharaoh and his chariots and charioteers." The angel of God, who had been leading Israel's camp, now moved and went around behind them. The column of cloud also, leaving the front, took up its place behind them, so that it came between the camp of the Egyptians and that of Israel. But the cloud now became dark, and thus the night passed without the rival camps coming any closer together all night long. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord swept the sea with a strong east wind throughout the night, and so turned it into dry land. When the water was thus divided, the Israelites marched into the midst of the sea on dry land, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. The Egyptians followed in pursuit. All Pharaoh's horses and chariots and charioteers went after them, right into the midst of the sea. In the night watch, just before dawn, the Lord cast through the column of the fiery cloud upon the Egyptian force a glance that threw it into a panic. And he so clogged their chariot wheels that they could hardly move. With that, the Egyptians sounded the retreat before Israel, because the Lord was fighting for them against the Egyptians. Then the Lord told Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea, that the water may flow back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and their charioteers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn, the sea flowed back to its normal depth. The Egyptians were fleeing head-on toward the sea when the Lord hurled them into its midst. As the water flowed back, it covered the chariots and the charioteers of Pharaoh's whole army, which had followed the Israelites into the sea. Not a single one of them escaped. But the Israelites had marched on dry land through the midst of the sea with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. Thus, the Lord saved Israel on that day from the power of the Egyptians. When Israel saw the Egyptians lying dead on the seashore and beheld the great power that the Lord had shown against the Egyptians, they feared the Lord and believed in him and in his servant Moses. Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord. I will sing to the Lord, for he is gloriously triumphant. Horse and chariot he has cast into the sea. The word of the Lord.
I will sing to my God who delivers me from death into life, into freedom through the sea. I will sing to my God who delivers me from death into life, into freedom through the sea. The forces of darkness you hurled in the sea, your power, your hand has delivered me. I will sing to my God who delivers me from death into life, into freedom through the sea.
Let us pray. O God, whose ancient wonders remain undimmed in splendor even in our day, for what you once bestowed on a single people, freeing them from Pharaoh's persecution by the power of your right hand, now you bring about as the salvation of the nations through the waters of rebirth. Grant, we pray, that the whole world may become children of Abraham and inherit the dignity of Israel's birthright. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, all you who are thirsty, come to the water. You who have no money, come, receive grain and eat. Come without paying and without cost. Drink wine and milk. Why spend your money for what is not bread, your wages for what fails to satisfy? Heed me, and you shall eat well. You shall delight in rich fare. Come to me heedfully. Listen, that you may have life. I will renew with you the everlasting covenant, the benefits assured to David. As I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander of nations, so shall you summon a nation you knew not. And nations that knew you not shall run to you because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, who has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way and the wicked man his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God, who is generous in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, says the Lord, nor are your ways my ways. As high as the heavens are above the earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. For just as from the heavens and the earth, the rain and snow come down and do not return there until they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, sole hope of the world, who by the preaching of your prophets unveiled the mysteries of this present age, graciously increase the longing of your people, for only at the prompting of your grace do the faithful progress in any kind of virtue, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Lord,
Son. Lord, the Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen. Glory, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will.
Let us pray. O God, who make this most sacred night radiant with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your church a spirit of adoption, so that renewed in body and mind, we may render you in the undivided service. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in the newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like his, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For a dead person has been absolved from sin. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as being dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.
Christ, our Paschal Lamb, has been sacrificed. Let us then feast with joy in the Lord.
My brothers and sisters, may the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven, approached, rolled back the stone, and sat upon it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. The guards were shaken with fear of him and became like dead men. Then the angel said to the women in reply, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are seeking Jesus the crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples he has been raised from the dead, and he has gone before you to Galilee. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you." Then they went away quickly from the tomb, fearful yet overjoyed, and ran to announce this to his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them on the way and greeted them. They approached, embraced his feet, and did him homage. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go then, my brothers, to Galilee, and there they will see me." My brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
It's good to see all of you since April 2020. Is that right? No. April 2019, because in 2020 we have not been here in this church. So thanks be to God, we are in the church this year. We have made progress, and now we can just praise the Lord and enjoy this beautiful time of the year, the resurrection of Jesus Christ. So I would like to welcome each one of you, my dear St. Joseph parishioners, visitors, all brothers and sisters, all believers. But most especially, I would like to welcome our candidates, catechumens, and elect. Those of you who will receive holy baptism and confirmation. And I would like to remind you who is going to receive baptism this year. So that will be Dominic Reynoso, Jesus Reynoso, Irma Reynoso, also from Parker family, Ivy Parker, Angela Parker. We have also Emmett Walker, Giordano Scarano. So these individuals will receive holy baptism tonight, and also we will receive, we have those who will receive their confirmation. So at this time we have John Seeger and David Dwyer. Do we have one more? One more person? Yes? Okay. You will also receive the holy baptism. Yes. Okay. So you can sit, all of you. Okay. We have Rudy Ponce here who will receive the Holy Sacrament. Okay. So my brothers and sisters, this is the most blessed and most joyful night of the year as we celebrate Jesus' resurrection. And we are so accustomed to hearing of Jesus risen from the dead, that we could say, oh yes, we know all about it. And if we say that, we miss the grace of entering fully into the celebration. But think about it. Jesus rose from the dead. Death is not the end. It is only the door to beyond. Let us not allow the resurrection of Jesus to have to fight for room in our lives. Let Jesus' death and resurrection be the center of our lives. And we begin our celebration tonight with a service of light at the back of the church, which symbolized Jesus rising from the dead. And the light of Christ has shone in the world, scattering darkness forever. We had been waiting for this moment, well, for thousands of years. We heard in the readings tonight an account of the creation of man and woman. That was the first reading. And also the liberation of the Hebrews from Egypt. That was the second reading. This was in God's plan for mankind. But the high point in God's plan for us was the resurrection. And this is the greatest celebration of the church. My brothers and sisters, this night is the most blessed of all, as we heard in the exalted, the Easter proclamation. Jesus' resurrection reminds us that there is life beyond the grave. Jesus' resurrection reminds us that there is more to each of us than meets the eye, that we have an immortal soul. Although our body will return to dust, our soul will live forever with God. So what is the purpose of our life? Think about it, my brothers and sisters. What is your goal in life? Where is your heart in your life? Life has only one ultimate goal: to prepare for the next life. And if you are not preparing for your own resurrection, you are like a train that has become derailed. So what happens to a train that gets derailed? It's a big mess, we know that, yes? But it goes nowhere. Can you take your possessions to heaven? No, we cannot take it. Then why make such a fuss sometimes about your house? Can we take our cars to heaven? Well, then why become so engrossed in your car? Can we take our bank accounts I know it's important to have money, some possessions, but we will not take them to heaven. My brothers and sisters, use your money, use your possessions for the spread of the gospel. So why are we so busy that we have no time to pray to God every day? Sometimes people come to me and say, Father, I'm so busy. I'm so busy with this life. I don't have time to pray. Well, what can I say? At the end, when we will die, and when I see people very often in hospitals, Manatee Hospital, Blake Hospital, we go to hospice, we go to different places in this area, very often in the middle of the night. And the only thing people want is the piece of bread, Jesus. When we come to see them, they say, Father, thank you for coming at 2 a.m., 7 p.m., 9 a.m., every time of the day, and they thank the priest for bringing the most precious host, Jesus Christ our Lord. They never talk about how many possessions they have. They never talk about how many houses they have, boats, cars. I mean, it's important to have it, but just not to have it as the purpose of our lives. My brothers and sisters, think of the glorious future that awaits each of us. In the letter to the Romans, which we heard tonight, Paul wrote that we will imitate Christ in his resurrection. And also Paul wrote to the Philippians. He said, for us, our homeland is in heaven, and from heaven comes the Savior we are waiting for, the Lord Jesus Christ. And he will transfigure these wretched bodies of ours into copies of his glorious body. My friends, just think of it. You will be transformed to become glorious like Jesus. So do I live like someone who believes in such a glorious future? If you do, surely everything in this world takes on a new perspective. So that, as I said earlier, we do not become possessed by our possessions. And the reason we have so many problems, my brothers and sisters, in the world and also in the church, is because we don't pray enough. Pray, pray, pray. Again, what is life all about? Saint Paul says, once again, our homeland is in heaven, and from heaven comes the Savior we are waiting for, the Lord Jesus Christ, and he will transfigure these wretched bodies of ours into copies of his glorious body. Beautiful words from Saint Paul. And John also in his first letter says something similar. He says, my dear people, we are already children of God, but what we are to be in the future has not yet been revealed. All we know is that when it is revealed, we shall be like him because we shall see him as he really is. Our second reading at Mass tomorrow morning concludes. It says, but when Christ is revealed and he is your life, you too will be revealed in all your glory with him. So my brothers and sisters, why can we expect such a glorious future? Why? Because we are baptized, or we will be baptized. And that is why baptism is so important. When we are baptized, we are adopted by God as his very own sons and daughters. In the same letter, John says, think of the love that the Father has lavished on us by letting us be called God's children, and that is what we are. You were adopted by God as his son and daughter on the day you were baptized. And my dear elect, once you will be baptized, think about this day, April 3rd, 2021, very special day. Think of what happened to you or what will happen to you on the day you were or will be baptized. You will be born again. You will become a son and daughter of God. In our New Testament reading tonight, we heard Paul tell the Romans that when we were baptized, we left behind our old life. So we entered the tomb with Jesus and rose again to new life. So what he means is that when we were baptized, we took on a new lifestyle, leaving sin behind to live a new life with Christ, because we became sons and daughters of God. The three women in the gospel came to the tomb wondering who would roll away the stone for them. And perhaps they hope the soldiers keeping guard would roll it away for them to allow them anoint Jesus' body. But when they got there, the stone was already rolled away. So think about it. Have you allowed a stone to prevent you from meeting the risen Jesus? Have you allowed the stone of becoming engrossed in what you have and own and what others have and own be a stone to block your way to Jesus? Let's remember, you were adopted as God's son and daughter on the day you were baptized. If you are not living like a son or daughter of God, well, roll away the stone, my brothers and sisters. If you are not happy, that is a sure sign that the stone needs to be rolled away in your life. If you knew the risen Jesus, you would have such joy in your heart that nothing else could give you. And think of the total change that occurred in Paul's life after he met Jesus on the road to Damascus. My friends, we must roll away the stone for that. And listen once again to this beautiful invitation from God in the third reading from tonight. It says, "Thus says the Lord, O come to the water, all you who are thirsty. Though you have no money, come, buy corn without money and eat, and at no cost wine and milk. Why spend money on what is not bread, your wages, and what fails to satisfy? Listen to me, and you will have good things to eat and rich food to enjoy. Pay attention, come to me. Listen, and your soul will live." My brothers and sisters, my dear elect, 9 of you here in this church, God has adopted you, and God will adopt you as his son and daughter. Thank God for this most wonderful privilege. If you had met the risen Jesus, you would certainly know it. If you haven't yet met the risen Jesus, well, roll away the stone. Accept God's invitation, as it was in our third reading tonight, and meet our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Dearly beloved, with one heart and one soul, let our prayers come to the aid of these who will approach the font of rebirth. May the Almighty Father bestow on all those approaching this font in the coming year his merciful help. Amen.
So now is the moment for baptism. So please stay in your pews, and we with the elect and with the deacons will go back to the baptismal font.
Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Mary and Joseph, pray for us. Michael and all angels. Anna, you welcome Elizabeth.
Pray for us.
Elijah, Moses, John the Baptist.
Pray for us.
Isaac, Sarah, Abraham.
Pray for us.
Jacob, Joseph, Samuel.
Pray for us.
Mother Teresa and Saint Lucia.
Pray for us.
Saint Benedict and Saint Thomas Aquinas.
Pray for us.
And Cornelius, Prisca and Aquila, Timothy and Titus, Linus, Cletus and Clement.
God, who by invisible power accomplish a wondrous effect through sacramental signs, and who in many ways have prepared water, your creation, to show forth the grace of baptism. O God, whose Spirit in the first moments of the world's creation hovered over the waters so that the very substance of water would even then take to itself the power to sanctify. O God, who by the outpouring of the flood foreshadowed regeneration, so that from the mystery of one and the same element of water would come an end to vice and a beginning of virtue. O God, who caused the children of Abraham to pass dry shod through the Red Sea, so that the chosen people, set free from slavery to Pharaoh, would prefigure the people of the baptized. O God, whose Son, baptized by John in the waters of the Jordan, was anointed with the Holy Spirit, and as he hung upon the cross, gave forth water from his side along with blood, and after his resurrection, commanded his disciples, "Go forth, teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit." Look now, we pray, upon the face of your church, and graciously unseal for her the fountain of baptism. May this water received by the Holy Spirit the grace of your only begotten Son, so that human nature created in your image and washed clean through the sacrament of baptism from all the squalor of the life of old may be found worthy to rise to the life of the newborn children through water and the Holy Spirit. May the power of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, we pray, come down through your Son into the fullness of this fund, so that all who have been buried with Christ by baptism into death may rise again to life with him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. So my dear elects, so all of these elect gathered here on this blessed night, I will ask you questions, and after each question you will respond, "I do." Do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children? Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin? Do you reject Satan, father of sin and prince of darkness? Do you reject Satan and all his works and all his empty promises? And all of these elect gathered here on this blessed night, do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father? Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? So at this moment, I would like to call Reynoso family. First will be Dominic for baptism. Okay. Be careful. So you're Dominic, yes? Dominic, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay. Just wait. Yeah, very nice. Yes, now we have Jesus. Jesus, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We have now Irma. Irma, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. This moment we have the Parker family. Ivy is first. Just kneel here, okay? So Ivy, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Congratulations. Angela Parker. Can you hear? Angela, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now we have Emmett Walker. Yeah, just 1 minute. Okay. Take some pictures, that's important. Emmet, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Giordano Scarano. Giordano, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So at this moment, I'd like to address the community. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, after each question we will respond, I do. Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
Please join in singing Baptized in Water, found on your worship aid, second side.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. Amen.
Of salvation.
of power and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ has freed you from sin and brought you to new life through water and the Holy Spirit. He now anoints you with the chrism of salvation so that united with his people, you may remain forever a member of Christ, who is priest, prophet, and king. Amen. At this moment, I will anoint Dominic, because Dominic is the one who will receive only the sacrament of baptism. So Dominic will receive the anointing of the chrism on the crown of his head. So all the newly baptized have become a new creation and have clothed themselves in Christ. Receive this baptismal garment. So put your garments on. And bring this baptismal garment unstained to the judgment seat of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that you may have everlasting life. Amen. And now, godparents, please come forward to give to the newly baptized the light of Christ. And you can light your candle from the Easter candle. Yeah, thank you. Very good. Please light the candle. Ivy and your sponsors. Hey, my friends, you have been enlightened by Christ. Walk always as children of the light and keep the flame of faith alive in your hearts. When the Lord comes, may you go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. Amen. And now we will process into to the altar.
And during that procession, we sing, "Breathe on me, O breath of God."
This time we ask John Seeger and David Dwyer to come and join the newly baptized. So John and David have been baptized in another Christian faith tradition. On this blessed night, they will be joining this newly baptized to receive confirmation and later the Eucharist. These candidates will be joyfully welcomed into full communion with the Catholic Church this holy night. So, my dear candidates for confirmation, by your baptism, you have been born again in Christ and you have become members of Christ and of his priestly people. Now you are to share in the outpouring of the Holy Spirit among us, the Spirit sent by the Lord upon his apostles at Pentecost and given by them and their successors to the baptized. The promised strength of the Holy Spirit, which you are to receive, will make you more like Christ and help you to be witnesses to his suffering, death, and resurrection. It will strengthen you to be active members of the Church and to build up the body of Christ in faith and love. My dear friends, let us pray to God our Father that he will pour out the Holy Spirit on these candidates for confirmation, to strengthen them with his gifts and anoint them to be more like Christ, the Son of God. Let us pray. All-powerful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit, you freed your sons and daughters from sin and gave them new life. Send your Holy Spirit upon them to be their helper and guide. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of right judgment and courage, the spirit of knowledge and reverence. Fill them with the spirit of wonder and awe in your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And at this moment, the confirmation of the candidates will take place. Saint Joseph, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you and with your spirit. Saint Thomas the Apostle, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you and with your spirit. Saint Benedict, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you Saint Joseph, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Saint Mary of Magdalene, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Saint Joseph, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Saint Elizabeth, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Saint Lucia, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. So congratulations. For the newly confirmed, please return to your places, and sponsors, please be seated. So now please stand for the prayer of the faithful. Like the women who came to the tomb to seek the Lord, we seek the Lord's presence in our lives and the lives of our neighbors around the world.
For the church, let all who know the risen Christ be alive with his healing and forgiving love, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the newly baptized and those fully initiated into the Catholic Church be always awake to see signs of the resurrection and to proclaim the goodness of the God of life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the nations, that a new day dawn in the relations between East and West, rolling back barriers to understanding and goodwill, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For continuous coordinated efforts amongst individuals, nations, and societies as we all work together to prevent further spread of the coronavirus, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and infirm experience resurrection grace according to God's purpose, including Grace Brown, John Goose, Richard Defector, Dennis Lynn, Bill Glynn, Annie Wagner, David Elias, John and Joanne Sinclair, John and Robin Schmaltz, and Rory Hatch, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead be united with Christ in everlasting life, including Ruth Plymire, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In the silence of our hearts, let us present to God all of our prayers and intercessions. And for Bill Schlacks, for whom we remember in a special way in this liturgy, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of life, you raised your Son from the dead to join you in life everlasting. You have given us new life in baptism and promised the gift of eternal life. Hear the prayers we make tonight and grant them through Jesus Christ, your Son, our risen Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
And we join in singing our hymn of preparation.
My sacrifice and yours may
may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept our sacrifice
for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the glory of his holy church. Accept, we ask, O Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in the Paschal Mysteries may, by the working of your power, bring us to the healing of eternity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
But on this night, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. By sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Celebrate the
the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Frank, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also, Lord, the newly baptized, who through baptism and confirmation have today been joined to your family, that they may follow Christ your Son with our generous heart and our willing spirit. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
But on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Thank you.
night, I turn to them, reborn by water and the Holy Spirit, receive for the first time the bread of life. May the body of Christ, the Lord, always make you grow in his friendship and also in communion with the whole church. May it be the constant food for the journey of your life and a pledge of the eternal banquet of heaven. Amen. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. May the blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Christ.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, the Holy Spirit. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. The body of Christ.
I know it's very late, and we have masses tomorrow morning. We start at 6:30, so busy weekend. But once again, thank you very much for being here. Thank you for all those who are watching us online, on our Facebook page, on YouTube. Thank you very much. Enjoy this beautiful time of the year. And finally, resurrection, that's the most important event in our Christian calendar, in our Catholic calendar. Once again, many blessings to our newly baptized, our candidates, catechumens, elects. Once again, I will say the names: Dominic Reynoso, Jesus Reynoso, Irma Reynoso, Ivy Parker, Angela Parker, Emmett Walker, Giordano Scarano, Rudy, Piedra y Ponce. Also we have John Seeger and David Dwyer. Thank you once again. Congratulations again. So at this moment, I would like to ask the neophytes to come to the first step of the sanctuary to be presented to the people of God for the first time on this blessed night. And after the final blessing, after the Mass, you can congratulate them. And just I wish you all the best. Have a blessed night. Thank you. Pour out on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this Paschal sacrament one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please bow your heads for God's blessing. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin. Amen. And may he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten, endow you with the price of immortality. Amen. Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you, who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal feast, come with Christ's help and exalting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.